揽投资国内专业的互联网理财平台，收益超银行活期数倍，已为众多用户带来丰厚收益。揽投资理财新选择，
源于民族之心，兴于品质之巅，成于健康之路，有爱有缘有三元。
除了大气污染之外，气候变化也是全球面临的环境难题，需要各国通力合作，共同采取应对措施。1997年，联合国气候变化框架公约缔约方第三次大会上通过的京都议定书，作为人类历史上第一个限制温室气体排放的国际法律文件，是世界各国集体应对气候变化的一个里程碑，也是迄今为止唯一的应对气候变化的国际条约。中国也于1998年5月签署并于2002年核准了京都议定书。格雷西拉·齐齐尔尼斯基教授曾广泛地参与了京都议定书的草拟工作，并设计与制定了在2005年成为国际公法一部分的碳市场。在他看来，签署京都议定书后，中国在应对气候变化方面的角色更加重要了，应该更多地参与到碳市场交易之中。提及即将于2015年底于巴黎举行的联合国气候大会，齐齐尔尼斯基也建议中国应积极地提出切实可行的环保建议。
So from signing the Kyoto Protocol we mentioned before, and to the joint announcement with the United States, what do you think of the transition of China's role, China's function in combating climate change?
The European Union, the nations that participate in the carbon market of the Kyoto Protocol is called the European Union Emission Trading System. The nations, the European nations that participate in that European Union emission trading system are the only nations in the world that have reduced their emissions. That's the lesson. It works. The carbon market at the global level works. How much did they reduce? Some reports in the year 2012 and 2011 are approximately 30 and 36% reductions of emissions. That's huge. That only happened in the nations that were trading and were part of the carbon market in the Kyoto Protocol, the European Union Emission Trading System nations. They are the example. They have made things work. And China can participate in that market, but only if it accepts limits.
We know China is putting a lot of efforts in cleaning the air and solve the air pollution issues. What's the significance of all those efforts, actions to the rest of the world, to the other countries?
Now China has to make a proposal. The same positive way in which China is creating the BRICS Bank, it has to create a positive proposal in the COP21 negotiations. It can be done. And the proposal should represent the interest of the developing nations who have the future of the global economy in their hand, and also the future of the human society. Since the year 2000, the majority of the growth, economic growth in the world, did not come from the rich countries, came from the poor nations. Therefore, the whole dynamics of the world economy is in the poor nations. China should play an important role in bringing forth clean development. I think the Chinese government wants to do it, definitely wants to do it, and it can happen. So my advice is that in the area of the Bretton Woods global finance, China created, together with other nations, the BRICS Bank. It's a way to say the developing nations and the nations involved in the BRICS Bank can change global finance. And instead of being denominated in dollars, so my suggestion is that China should take the global environmental issue with the same level of urgency that it took the global finance issue, creating an international bank for environmental settlements at the same time as a BRICS Bank. So whatever global finance is developed by the BRICS Bank, it should be consistent with the global environment. That is critical for China and is critical for the world.